In the design process, you have to communicate your ideas with the other stakeholders in the project, such as the owner, engineers, and constructors. All of these usually need different formats that are suited to their applications. ARCHICAD provides users with efficient and fine-tuned publishing procedures. You may continue working on the current project, or open the TS03 Chapter 9 PLN ARCHICAD Solo project file to complete this chapter of the training series. If the library manager appears and informs you that the training textures are unavailable, then click the Add button at the bottom of the dialog. Select the Training Textures folder. This is located in the Training Files folder of the downloaded guide. Click Choose to add this folder, and then click OK to proceed. The traditional way of documentation is to publish sets of projected views, like floor plans, sections, elevations, details, and some renderings. The live model projections ensure that all the published project views and documents will be fully updated and present the current or latest design stage. Once all the views are set, you can easily create virtual sheets in the layout book area of the Navigator. The standard template contains a predefined set of layouts based on the local standards. If you use a localized version of the program, you may find a different layout and numbering structure here. We're using the international version. Let's explore the content of the layout book first. Display the layout book by clicking its icon in the Navigator. Open some floor plans and elevations to see their content. The placed drawings automatically display the model. Open the West Elevation layout from the layout book. The appearance is nice, but it does not meet our standards. We need fewer trees and more graphical details, such as textures and shadows. We can set this for all our sections and elevations together. Let's start with elevations. Open the project map in the Navigator. Select all elevations. Click the Settings button on the Properties area. Display the Model Display Panel of the Elevation Settings dialog. Make the following modifications. Check Uniform Pen for cut elements. Check Uniform Pen for uncut elements. Check Vectorial 3D Hatching. Check Transparency. Check Sun Shadows. Check Marked Distant Area. Check Uniform Pen for uncut elements. Check Vectorial 3D Hatching. Check Sun Shadows. Leave all the pen settings as they are. Click OK to apply these changes. Open the West Elevation view in the layout book of the Navigator. If the automatic update is turned off, you may use the Rebuild from Model option from the context menu to update the placed drawing on the layout. The graphical appearance of the elevation is updated. It's almost perfect, but the entrance door is faded. This is because the distance area is too close. Let's fix this problem in the floor plan view. Open the ground floor in the view map of the Navigator. Select the West Elevation marker on the ground floor. A secondary line appears, indicating where the faded parts starts. This is a screen-only line and will not appear in any of the printed documents. Click the hot spot in the middle and select the Move Elevation Line Segment option on the PET palette. Drag the hot spot so the building is between the two lines of the elevation marker, as shown on the screen. Repeat with the other elevation lines as well. Select the elevation markers on the floor plan one by one and drag the line segment so that the building is in between the two lines of the marker. Let's adjust the representation of the sections. Select both sections in the project map of the Navigator. Open their settings dialog and display the model display panel. Make the same modifications as earlier. Check uniform pen for cut elements. Check uniform pen for uncut elements. Check vectorial 3D hatching. Check transparency. Check sun shadows. Check marked distant area. Check uniform pen for uncut elements. Check vectorial 3D hatching. Check sun shadows. Click OK to proceed. Now let's go back to the layout book and see the results. Open the West Elevation layout. The view is automatically updated and reflects the latest changes. Open the West Elevation in the view map to add some 2D trees to this view. Select the Object tool in the toolbox and open its Settings dialog. Select the Deciduous Trees object from the Visualization Site Improvements Garden folder. Enter 0.00 degrees for rotation on the Preview and Positioning panel. Display the Deciduous Tree Settings panel. Select Maple for the tree type. Open the 2D Representation panel. Change the view type to Side View. Select the Foggy Symbol type. Make sure that the Site and Landscaping Terrain layer is selected. Click OK. Place this tree on the right side of the building on the West Elevation view. Open the Object Settings dialog once more to place another tree. Open the Deciduous Tree Type page of the Tree Settings panel. Select the Linden tree type this time. Switch to the 2D Representation panel using the arrow button. Select the Foggy Symbol type. Click OK. And place another tree on the left side of the building as well. You may change the display orders of the trees in Mesh if necessary. To do this, first select both trees on the West Elevation and use the Display Order Send to Back option of the context menu. Open the West Elevation layout from the layout book or simply from the tab bar to check the results. Let's see what we can set at the drawing level. Select the elevation drawing on the layout and open its settings dialog. On the identification panel, you can change the automatic naming and numbering if necessary. You can also change the update type to manual if you don't want the drawing to be updated. This way, you can freeze a certain state of the drawing's content while you can work on the model. On the size and appearance panel, you can set the scale and aspect ratio, as well as the anchor point. You can also choose a pen set and colors that will set the printing and plotting style. Change to black and white in the colors list to overwrite color settings. This way, all lines will be printed in black, keeping the pen weight of the original pen set. Display the frame panel. The drawing has a boundary that can have any shape. By default, it is rectangular, adjusted to the drawing's content. By default, it is screen only, but you can make it printable too. Leave the settings as they are. Display the title panel. You can assign different title blocks to the display information about the drawing automatically, such as scale, name, ID, and so on. Select the built-in drawing title option. The parameters appear in the list, so you can customize them if needed. Leave all the settings as they are for now, and click OK. Please note that the appearance of the drawing has changed to black and white, and the drawing title appears at the bottom.